holiness, holiness, it's what I long for. Holiness, it's what I.
Hello, family. Once again, welcome to Daily Rhema with your General Superintendent, Stephen Yenusom Wengam. Still on the theme, holiness, holiness for revival, the theme for 2023. And as I mentioned earlier on, the word holiness is found over 800 times in the scriptures, meaning it is a core part of our Christian faith, something God wants us to pursue at all costs. Today we are looking at part two of perfecting holiness, 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1 to verse number 10. I'll pick a few relevant verses. Therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. In this particular exhortation, last week I touched on two areas, the call to be holy and the content of holy living. And I ended on the content of holy living. In verse 1, Paul calls on us to be holy at all costs for good reasons. And then we look at the content of holy living. We said, number one, sanctification as found in verse number 1, walking in the fear of the Lord. Number 2, being blameless. Number 3, staying away from corruption. Then number 5, not using our position to take advantage of people. And then possessing a positive attitude in times of affliction. Now the next content of holiness is exhibiting genuine repentance, when the Holy Spirit convicts us of sin, of righteousness, and of judgment. Verse 8 to verse number 12 of 2 Corinthians chapter 7. For even if I made you sorry with my letter, I do not regret it, though I did regret it. For I perceive that the same epistle made you sorry, though only for a while. Now I rejoice not that you were made sorry, but your sorrow led to repentance. So another component of holy living, another thing that perfects our holiness, is exhibiting genuine, sincere repentance when we are confronted with our sin, when the Holy Spirit convicts us of our unholy living. Then another thing that perfects our holy living is when we live up to divine expectations. 2 Corinthians 7, verse number 14, what does the word of God say? For if in anything I have boasted to him about you, I am not ashamed, but as we spoke all things to you in truth, even so our boasting to Titus was found through. So here he's saying that he was boasting about the believers at Corinth. It means that they measured up to the holiness of God. So we perfect holiness when our lives match up to God's expectations of holiness, especially in conformity with the word of God. Verse 15 talks about obedience. We perfect our holiness when we are committed to obeying the word of God. 2 Corinthians 7, verse number 15, and I read, and his affections are greater for you as he remembers the obedience of you all, how with fear and trembling you receive him. The obedience of you all. Obedience perfects our holiness. Obedience to God's word. Obedience to authority. Then the last but not the least component of holy living, when we honor leadership. Watch verse 15. When we honor leadership, he says, and his affections are greater for you as he remembers the obedience of your faith, how with fear and trembling you received him. You know that spiritual leadership or any leadership represents God. Romans 13, 1 and 2. So when you submit to leadership, when you honor leadership, you perfect holiness, you perfect righteousness. Now, what is the credit? So I look at the call to holy living, the content of holy living, and the credit, the crown of holy living. Looking at verse 1 again, he says, therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness. So the benefit of perfecting holiness is that the promises of God are fulfilled, established, manifested in our lives. I choose holiness. I urge you and your family to choose holiness. Holiness for revival. God bless you.